should lead your digital transformation? It's an excellent question. And I think there's some very heated political battles going on in companies and organizations all over the world about the right strategy and the right person to lead this. In some companies, IT is holding on to websites and digital things with a kung fu grip. They're holding on to it for dear life. And that can be fine as long as there's people on their team that actually get that the company's website that was successful in 2007 or 2012 isn't the same company website and company strategy that's going to make your company able to be successful and compete and relevant today. So IT sometimes takes on these roles. Marketing many times takes on these roles, and marketing is a worthy contender to be leading digital transformation as long as your marketing leadership also really gets how much the buyer's journey has changed, gets how much your industry is being disrupted, truly understands your buyer personas and how they go through the buyer's journey and what kind of experience they're looking for in your company. They're a worthy contender. Sales can also be a worthy contender. Your chief sales officer, your chief revenue officer, if they really have a strong grasp on what marketing needs to be doing to keep the sales funnel full, and surely your sales director, your sales team spends a lot of time talking to end customers, feet in the trenches, so they should have a really good idea and really good pulse of what's needed for your company to be digitally relevant. They're certainly hearing all the time about how their company stacks up against the competition. And some companies, besides having a CIO or CTO, Chief Information Officer, Chief Technology Officer, battling to lead the digital transformation. Again, there's CMOs or marketing directors, Chief Marketing Officers battling for this. In some cases, it's a Chief Sales or Chief Revenue Officer. And some cases, there's a new title that we've seen emerge recently too, the CMTO, Chief Marketing Technology Officer. That's kind of a blend between marketing and IT. And in some really progressive companies, there's Chief Digital Officers, CDOs. Every once in a while, we see Chief Transformational Officers. Obviously, in a smaller company, many times the CEO is going to wear these kinds of hats. And these are all really important conversations to have, and it's critical that your teams not be siloed on this and that they're all working together on this. And this is part of the reason why this has to start from the top down. This is a C-level type of problem. If you kick this down to thinking that it just should live in your IT silo, big mistake. If you kick this down to thinking it just should live in your marketing silo, big, big mistake. These are strategic differentiation issues that are going to either make sure that your company stays relevant and stays on the map for the next several years with the right people that you're trying to attract in the right kind of context, or your company can get completely bulldozed by competitors who get this a lot more, and you're going to be on the bad side of digital transformation and likely to become digitally disrupted. I don't think you have to look very hard to see dozens of examples that even one single company, look at like Amazon and how much Amazon is reshaping everything. What's interesting too is people out of IT, outside of the IT industry, don't realize how much Amazon has disrupted hosting and cloud services and IT services and everything with their AWS division. Amazon Web Services and Microsoft has their Azure initiative. IBM and Google are in a big time way in that space with cloud services too. But it's a heck of a lot better when you think about this stuff proactively and know exactly what your company is planning to do, who's going to do it, who's going to lead the charge, what the blueprint, what the roadmap looks like to digitally transform your company, as opposed to waking up one day and realize that sales are plummeting, our market share is plummeting, our margins are atrocious, all because there was a couple other companies that we didn't see coming, or we did see coming, and we're like, it's the whole internet thing, it's a fad, nobody uses search engines, nobody uses social media, they have iPhones, but they don't use it for that, right? No, it's really, really critical that you have a really strong pulse on who your ideal buyers are, how they look at companies like yours, how they go through that whole buyer's journey and what your company is going to do to be relevant and to be in a leadership position in your space to survive and thrive in the future.